Hello everybody, today we will present to you our work entitled Analysis of Interaction Among Infrastructure Provider Front-end Component Provider, realized by Hamid Garmani, Mohamed Amrani, Driss et Omar, Mohamed Ouaskou, and Mohamed Baslam from Sultan Moulay Slimane University. To do so, we follow this outline. We start by an introduction, problem modeling, Stackelberg game, price game, numerical result, and conclusion. Introduction. With the rapid growth of global data traffic, which achieved 2.5 exabyte per month in 2014 and exceeded 24.3% exabyte per month by the end of 2022, content provider host several cache server by using CDN to respond to users' requests. This is a technique to improve the quality of service, but is not the best solution as it has the following weaknesses. Firstly, content provider do not have information on the topology, which is hosted by the infrastructure provider. Therefore, it's hard for content provider to make the best decision. Secondly, it's hard to guess which cache server is the best one that must respond to the user's request. Thirdly, for some content provider, it's expensive for them to manage their individual cache server, which limit the application of CDNs. The infrastructure provider can record a content request on the network by using SDN. In addition, it has complete information on the topology. Motivated by this point, we suggest a novel architecture in which the infrastructure provider hosts all the cache servers. In this work, we investigate the interplay between infrastructure provider as a function of one market parameter, which is network access price. Then we study a game between infrastructure provider as a non-cooperative game. We use the Stackelberg game to analyze the interaction between infrastructure provider and content providers. We prove the existence and uniqueness of the Nash equilibrium of the non-cooperative game. We show in the numerical result the impact of system parameters on the provider's policies. Problem modeling. This figure shows the monetary flow among different entities. We consider a network with several users, an infrastructure provider and one content provider. Each infrastructure provider G chooses a price rho G and the content provider chooses cache name price C. Demand function. The user's demand for HTML given by the equation 1 are affected by one market parameter price rho, where sigma GL is the potential demand of user to HTML at the infrastructure provider G. Gamma GL ML is the responsiveness of the demand delta GL to price rho ML of HTML of infrastructure M. The demand delta GL of HTML decreases in the price rho GL and increases in the price rho GM. Utility model. The utility function sigma G of infrastructure provider G is the difference between the obtained payoff and the costs. The first term is all the revenue that the infrastructure provider G can get from the users. The other terms are how much the infrastructure provider should pay for the content that it requests from the content provider. The utility function of the content provider is the sum of payments got from all the infrastructure providers. The Stackelberg game is a game between two sets of players, leaders and followers. At the first stage of Stackelberg game, the content provider fixes the cache price C. At the second stage, given the cache price C, the infrastructure providers fix the price rho. Game formulation. Let theta L denote the non-cooperative price game, where M is the set of infrastructure provider, omega GL is the set of price, and sigma G is the utility function of infrastructure provider. Game analysis. In this stage of work, we define Nash equilibrium price for non-cooperative price game, and we prove the existence and uniqueness of Nash equilibrium. Learning Nash equilibrium. This algorithm summarizes the different steps to learn Nash equilibrium price of the non-cooperative price game. Numerical results. This figure shows the curve of the convergence to the Nash equilibrium price. We note that the best response algorithm converges to the unique Nash equilibrium price. In addition, the speed of convergence is relatively high. Also, this plot shows the impact of Gaussian price C on the Nash equilibrium price of several infrastructure providers. Then when Gaussian price C increases, the Nash equilibrium price increases too. It comes from the fact that when the Gaussian price is cheaper, the infrastructure providers lower their prices for attracting more users. On the other hand, when Gaussian price is expensive, infrastructure providers need to increase their price to compensate the increase of the Gaussian price. This plot demonstrates the utility function of content provider as a function of Gaussian price. Utility function increases with respect to the Gaussian price. It's clear that Gaussian increases content provider payoff. And also, this figure shows the utility function of several infrastructure providers with respect to the Gaussian cost C. Low Gaussian costs tend to yield higher utility compared to expensive Gaussian costs. Conclusion. In this work, we present a novel architecture in which the infrastructure provider deploys cache servers. We consider that the popularity of content follows a generalized Zipf distribution. We used a Stackelberg game to study the interaction between infrastructure provider and content provider. We investigate the competition between infrastructure providers by using a non-cooperative game. We proved the uniqueness of Nash equilibrium. And we have shown numerically the impact of system parameters on the provider policies. And thank you for your attention.